My name is Dan and today I'm gonna talk about how to max out faster your cars in Clash Royale. I know Mars Ultimate Gaming did the same type of video back in April, but I have in this video some tips that he didn't talk about. So with that said, enjoy the video. The first tip is going to include magic items. This is by far the most efficient way to max out a card in Clash Royale because the magic items just change the game forever. So what I want you to do is to choose a card that you want to max out. A common card, a rare card, an epic card and a legendary card. And I want you to focus on only these 4 cards. And basically all of wild cards that you get, wild common cards, wild rare cards, wild epic cards and wild legendary cards, you only need to use them on the 4 cards that you chose. Because it's much easier to max out a card than all of them at the same time. And that's basically how I maxed out my log and my knight. And the next is going to be this fireball because I have a book of books. And also the goblin barrel because I have a book of epic cards. The second tip is to get as many crowns as you can, and that means to do as many battles as you can. Because in that way you're not only gonna get a lot of crowns for crown chests, but you're also gonna get a lot of chests. A lot of silver chests, a lot of golden chests and even magical chests or legendary chests. And that means more cards. And with the crowns that you're gonna get a lot of crown chests. And this crown chest contains a lot of value because every time I open the entire free Clash Royale, I get like 3 legendaries every time from this crown chest. And if you don't believe me, go check out this YouTube video. As I was speaking about the Clash Royale, the third tip is to always complete all the 35 tires of this free Clash Royale. And because this video is about 9 ways to max out your cards in Clash Royale, we're not gonna talk about the Clash Royale that you can buy. And basically, if you complete all 35 tires, you're not only gonna get a book of epic cards like me, but you're also gonna get a lot of wild cards and especially wild legendary cards. And maybe even some legendaries. And as you can see, it is worth it, like 50 common wild cards, 5 epic wild cards, another 50 common wild cards, 10 wild rare cards, and this is just a lot of value for only 35 tires, especially if you have low level cards. A quick pause from the video because we have here a first place war chest, so let's just open it and just leave a like for it. I kinda want maybe Mother Witch, Electro Wizard or maybe even Sparky. Let's just see, 54 wild cards, that's going to be good. Arrows, and now 6 Dark Prince. What legendary are you gonna get? Just comment it in the comments. Bandit, wow! And I can upgrade it now to level 10. And by the way, the war chest is also a good way to get more cards in Clash Royale. The fourth tip to max out your cards in Clash Royale is to always request only rare cards. Yes, you heard it right. Only request rare cards because they are much harder to get than common cards. And as you can see here, the Ice Wizard does a good job because he just asked for Hog Riders. And he is going to max out the Hog Rider much faster than these guys that ask for common cards. I as well only request rare cards, and that's basically how I got my Hog Rider to almost level 13. And my Fireball to almost level 12, and after that to level 13. And by the way, I never asked for Tesla in Clash Royale, and as you can see, it is almost at level 13. I just got Tesla cards from unlocking chests, and that helped me a lot to concentrate on other rare cards that are more important than the Tesla, because I would have got Tesla either way. The fifth tip is to always donate in your clan because you also need gold to upgrade these cards to level max. And for every common card you donate, you're going to get 5 gold. For every rare card you donate, you're going to get 50 gold. And on every epic Sunday, make sure to donate as many epic cards as you can because for every epic card you donate, you are going to get 500 gold. And that, dudes, that's a lot of gold. And by the way, guys, make sure you don't donate the card that you actually want to upgrade to level max because that's just stopping your progress. And that's why I don't donate Hog Rider in my clan until I get it to level 13. The sixth tip is to always be aware of what cards are in the shop, because sometimes there can be good deals, and if you ever see a card that you want to max out, you should buy. And it doesn't matter if it's only one card or 50 cards. Buy those cards because you're going to max out much faster if you do that. And again, a quick side tip, don't you ever buy cards using gems. It is just a waste of gems and it is not worth it, because sometimes you can buy 5 epics with 250 gems. Supercell, what are you doing? The seventh tip is to always get your daily victory gold. Every day if you get 20 wins, you are going to get rewarded with gold, based on what arena are you in. For example, I get 50 gold for every win I get because I'm in the legendary arena. And for example, if you are in arena 12 in Spooky Town, you are going to get 24 gold for every win you get. You can get these 20 wins in every 1v1, 2v2 challenge possible in the game, only if those battles are not friendly battles. And by the way, if you were watching this gameplay, can you guess who won? This Hog Rider goes to the tower and an earthquake, and that means I won. This 2.6 Hog Earthquake Cycle deck is just mental. In the 8th tip, I'm going to talk about gems, and basically, don't waste your gems on legendary chests or even emotes, if you are not maxed out. And as you can see, I have here 500 gems, and that means I could easily get a legendary chest or even 2 emotes from the shop. And this baby dragon emote is really interesting, but I'm not gonna buy it, because you can get more value from these 500 gems if you use them in a global tournament. And as you can see here, with 500 gems I can get a legendary chest, 10k gold, a legendary trade token, an epic chest, and another 10k gold. And by the way, I didn't play very seriously in this triple elixir tournament, but basically you only need to get 15 wins to get the best value out of these 500 gems. And don't ever reroll for 10 gems, because these 10 gems you can use for playing in a classic challenge. And because I was talking about challenges, the 9th tip is to play classic or grand challenges. By playing these challenges, you're not only gonna get better at the game, but you're also going to get some good cards from this chest. Because if you get 12 wins in a classic or a grand challenge, you have also a good chance of getting a legendary every time. And because the legendary card is the hardest card to get in Clash Royale, this is also a good way to spend your gems. Because you also can get lucky and get a legendary from 0 wins in a classic challenge. And yes, I've seen that happen. So guys, this was the video, and these were my 9 tips to max out your cards much faster in Clash Royale. If I helped you with something, make sure to leave a like and subscribe, because these tips actually work for me, and as you can see, I wouldn't have got a level 13 legendary if I wouldn't used these tips. And by the way, my account is almost free to play, because I only bought the PES Royale 2 times. So with that said, if you enjoyed, just leave a like and subscribe. I was Anon, and I hope to see you in the next video. Bye. Can you win with a deck inspired by the Daily Fortune? Well, let's just find out. So my Daily Fortune is Skeleton, Fireball, Goblin Jill, and Golem. So I have 2 win conditions. These are the original cards, and you know what I have to do. I'm sorry, but I have to do it.
No! No!
Golem works very well with Night Witch, but if I put Mega Minion, Clone Spell, and Tornado, it can't be stopped. And I know it's an unskillful deck, but here am I doing an experiment, and I want to know how many battles it would take me to win with this deck. Well, I actually won, but you won't believe how many tries I had to do. I maybe only had to do 2 battles, or maybe only 7, or maybe 100. You won't know until you watch the YouTube video. The link is in the bio, but let me tell you, it is worth it. Thank you.